Good morning to all. Welcome to the online class. Myself, Mr. Asuk Mahapatra, assistant teacher, Sanskar Gurukul International School. We have to study about the economic development that is in the period of 1947 to 1990. During this period, it means during the just after the independence of India. After the independence of India, what was the economic progress in our country? And also, we will just focus to the economic progress, what has been done during the period of Britishers. So first, we will focus the economic development of our country during the period of Britishers, or you can say colonial government. Colonial government means during British rule. So first, we should remember that the Britishers already ruled over in India minimum for 150 years. So during that period, India not done any type of achievement in any type of field. So one by one, if we will focus, then we can know what is the present status and what was the status during the colonial government. So first, suppose we will give importance towards agriculture. So first, if we will focus towards agriculture, we can say during that period more than 85% people, they were the habitat of the village areas. They are probably all people, they settled in village. Urban area people were very few. So village people generally they depend upon cultivation. Cultivation is their major occupation. So if we focus towards the cultivation war during the colonial government, during the British government, we can say it was not at all satisfactory. Why? First, that we cannot say that any type of development work for agriculture. Suppose irrigation is required. For agriculture, we cannot depend on the monsoon rain as it is erratic in nature, as it is uncertain. Therefore, agriculture generally depends on irrigation. So during the colonial government, we can say irrigation facility was not at all there. It means they were not constructed any canals. Suppose in any hill regions or wherever rain is very scanty, wherever like Rajasthan area, wherever rainfall is very low, people get less than 50 centimeter rainfall. So how they will be associated in the cultivation work? Therefore, we can say British government has not done any type of improvement in the agricultural sector. Irrigation facility was at all not there. So those areas only getting rainfall, only people depending on the rainfall, they harvest their crops. So that is first thing. Second is land settlement. Land settlement is another important factor, because we can say all the cultivators having no own lands. They have not their own lands. Generally, they do the cultivation work in the land of the jamindars. During that period, jamindari system was there, particularly in West Bengal, Odisha, like states. Jamindari system was there. In jamindari system, what happened? One landlord having more than 50 acres of land, more than 20 acres of land, like that. Therefore, land was not properly distributed to all the people. Landlords having more than 20 acres of land, and so many say small land holders are there, extremely few land. Therefore, what happened? Whenever the cultivators, those are the poor cultivators, generally they depend on the lands of the jamindars. So jamindars, generally they try to exploit the poor cultivators. Whatever the situation will come, it means any natural hazards, if the cultivators will also face, but anyway they have to give the yields or products to the jamindars in proper proportion. So that was the rule. As well as there was at that time implementation of land revenue. Land revenue was another parameter that was implemented by British government. It means as per the land, the cultivator has to pay the revenue. Anyway, under any circumstances, you can't say the cultivator will not pay. It means any natural hazards, if the cultivators will face, any personal problems also will face, take it. So you have to say any personal problems also, if the cultivator will face, after that also he has to pay the land revenue to the government. So which was the very most important explanation to the small landholders, because any calamities, suppose natural famine or flood or say earthquake, what type of natural hazard they will face, after that also they have to pay the revenue, that is compulsory to the government. So for that reason, you can say the yield production, the production of yield, production of output, that was not satisfactory. Whatever the cultivator will predict, that he will not get. So this was the situation, this was the scenario in the field of agriculture. Then also you can say that due to the unuse of, it means as the cultivators having no ideas regarding the modern cultivation, regarding the modern technical methods, how to get more products, how to get more yields. Regarding this field also, British government was silent. British government has not taken any precautions for this case. For that reason, the product, it means the output, whatever the cultivator can expect, that he will never get. Next thing, there was no facility of infrastructure development. suppose cultivation product will be more, but in order to preserve the cultivated grains, in order to preserve the cultivated grains, there was no facility during that colonial government. Therefore, the cultivator is bound to sell the products at a low rate, for which he suffers a lot. Because due to any circumstances, if favorable condition will come, he will get more product due to the lack of preserving the food grains, he generally sells at a very low cost. Then another thing, we can say British government generally give more importance towards the cash crops. Cash crops, it means those crops like cotton, which will help for textile industry, and that product, say like jute, this type of product, the colonial government will take it as raw materials from India and will process it in their countries in order to get more profit, for which the Indian farmers unable to cultivate the food grains sufficiently, for which the people of India generally suffer. So, as a whole, in a nutshell, British government gave more emphasis towards cash crops instead of food grains. So, these are the drawbacks, these are the main drawbacks in the field of agriculture during the colonial government. So, now coming to second point, that is natural resources, contaminant of natural resources. We can say India was full of natural resources in different type of mineral resources, that is iron, semi-manganese, cobalt, limestone, whatever. But if we focus to the natural resources, during that period, colonial government never gave stress for the utilization of natural resources. There was no industry, there was no modern technical methods how to natural resources is going to be utilized for the country. More small scale industry, more large scale industry, they are totally not set up, and only very few were set up. Particularly during that period, TISCO, Tata Iron and Steel Company, which was set up in 1907, and after that you will find there was no large scale industry in India. And particularly, whatever the raw materials that was available, only people give importance towards cotton. So in India there were maximum cotton industry, but after that also colonial government tried to take all the raw materials, textile raw materials or cotton, to the British or Britain, and from there he will make the garments, and that is finally that will be sell in Indian market. So this was the scenario of industries in India during colonial government. So we can say lack of infrastructure, lack of modern techniques, these are though the main parameters are totally not there. Therefore India suffers a lot, though contaminant of natural resources was extremely more, and colonial government always tries to take the raw materials from India and to utilize it in Britain, and after that the products that will come to India for selling purpose. For that reason, the industrial sector faces a lot of problem during the colonial government. So your children. Next class we will discuss about the other parameters, what was their situation in colonial government. So you have to write a question for this chapter, that what was the situation of agricultural sector during colonial government. Thank you.